In the hushed presence of a vast plan, he traced the vestibule to the unseen, or listens following a bodice guide to a lonely cry in boundless vacancy. There is a greatness, there is a glory of the supramental light coursing in the members of Ashwapati. But there is also someone opposing it. The black inconscient dragon lashes her tail on the obscurities of form. Ashwapati would have returned to the parent sun. He would have vanished into it, into the source from which he came. But this dark obscurity makes him aware of the other part that needs to be taken care of. Godlike release that won't do for him. Ashwapati has become the pilgrim of the everlasting truth. And no more does he walk on the narrow roads of human time. He sees a vaster plan. He sees a brighter future. He sees a brilliant design. Through the long entrance hall to the house, he moves towards the inner rooms, the chambers of the unseen. The bodiless guide is there to take him where in silence dwells the one. Ashwapati's vacant mind becomes a blank slate, for the universal and the soul to write his drafts of idea truths and idea forces. His spirit mingles with eternity's heart. He bears the silence of the eternal. Mortal thought is left behind, and the climb is on the viewless, pathless summits. Even as he ascends the steps of wonder and joy, a strong descent leads down upon him. Might, flame, beauty, ecstasy, sweetness, they envelop him. They envelop his nerves and heart and brain. The physical experiences the thrill of the epiphany. There is a sudden intuitive perception, an insight into the reality, the essential meaning and content are seized. The entire outlook undergoes an immense change. All is known to his seeless eye. A wonderful order is discovered. Deathless countries of the One appear. These have opened out to him, and these he could explore. He could move freely through them.